three of a kind, two for two, and one full set are among the prizes on this week's 3-2-1. And now here he is, ladies and gentlemen, your host, Ted Rogers.
Thank you very much. Good evening. How do you do? Thank you. Thank you, everybody here in the studio. Thank you. Glad you've joined us at home. Welcome once again to the big one. Saturday treat, you just can't beat 3-2-1. Fabulous prizes, great guests for you to meet later on. And our theme for you this week is rock down the ages. Now, I don't know about you, but for me, rock started with Bill Haley. Do you remember Bill Haley? The fella with the kiss curl? Gosh, if for one curl he got a kiss, by now Tom Jones ought to have ringlets down to his knees, didn't he? Am I rock down the ages? Age is a thing that everyone's preoccupied with these days. That's why you've got to be in and see the doctor, regular checkups. I got one of these doctors in a group practice, you know, 15 of them all in one room. Well, one building anyway. The only thing is now, you don't take a bottle, you take a crate. <You see. laughs> Yes. Time now to come along and meet our little mascot, our fixture trickster, Dusty Bin. Here he is. Come on, Dusty. Oh, yes. Yes. Done himself up this week as a caveman, eh? A caveman. What are you trying to do? Get us in prehistoric hysterics? Now, listen. Hang about. Just a second. Dusty, you got it all wrong, and you can't fool me. That's not a Robosaurus at all. That's your dog Garbage. Look at the tail wagging, giving it away. You got it wrong. It's rock down the ages, not rock man, a caveman. What's the trunk for there? I mean, get away. All right, okay. He's hoping, the club, that our contestants are going to join the club of bin winners, which isn't very big, thank goodness for that. But we start, as always, with our quiz on 3-2-1. There are three couples, remember. They have a chance to go home with £1,000 each. One of them goes through right for the big prizes at the end. Later on, of course, for you folks at home, there is the viewer's question. So let's meet the people. If they didn't show, we wouldn't have a show. Our contestants, here they are. Yeah. And why not? A nice whistle, why not? Linda, nice outfit again, eh?
Thank you. You look very smart as well,
Ted. Well, perhaps the whistle was for me, eh? Who's couple number one this week?
Right, we have David Walker and Jackie Hughes from Liverpool.
Oh, great. From Liverpool, engaged couple, I see. Dave, yeah?
Yep.
And you're a motor mechanic, yeah?
That's right, yeah.
Busy work, eh? Right. Gotta be. Always busy these days. I went took my car into a garage the other day. I had a roll bar fitted. Now I've got the only car that serves hot dogs. Jack, I see you. You work for a firm that supplies bearings. What do you do exactly?
I do all the general office work, typing and invoicing, and the daily deliveries of bearings.
You're not looking forward much to washing Dave's mucky overalls, is that right?
No.
Oh, well, that's it.
Hang on, Walker broke out here already. Don't worry, now, Jackie, from what I know about mechanics, they never wipe their hands, mucky hands, on overalls. Only on steering wheels.
Of course.
You both like ice skating, yeah?
Yes.
Now, is that partaking in ice skating, or do you just watch or what?
Well, ice skate, Jackie falls over.
Pick me up.
Let's hope you're not going to fall over tonight and have your questions, shall we? Linda's got them. Which one do you want to choose? Number three, Jackie, okay. Now, you know, we like you answer alternately, of course. Ladies first, we give you one to start with, and for £10 for each correct answer in the first round. If you don't know an answer, just say pass or don't know. I'll go on to your partner with the next question. At least you can build up your score that way. But I do have to take the first answer or a part of the answer you give me, so be careful with guesses. Here's your question. It's about the names of people in the world of sport. We will give you a surname of an internationally known sports person, and we want you to give the first name by which they are best known. Now, Watson the golfer has the first name Tom. So we'll start you with that one. Watson and?
Tom.
Right. Becker.
Boris.
Lineker.
Pass.
McGuigan.
Buddy.
Shilton.
Pass.
Dury.
Pass.
Sanderson.
Pass.
Lyle.
Sandy.
Lauda.
Nicky.
And Connors.
Jimmy
Connors, that's right, yes. Sanderson, of course, was Tessa Sanderson, Shilton, Peter Shilton, and, of course, Dury, Joe Dury, and Lineker, the great Gary Lineker. At the end of that, you got six right. £60 is a nice start. Off you go with Linda. See you in round two as we welcome couple number two. Yes. Every week I say I don't know how you match these outfits, and they're so different. They're great, aren't they?
Yeah, beautiful.
And everyone's tall. So
I know,
yeah.
It's nice for us, isn't it?
Who's couple number two?
We have Nick Simpson and Yvonne Earle from Twickenham, Middlesex.
Oh, really? Yeah, I used to live at Ashford, not far from there. You know that? Yeah. Nick, your occupation, you're a draftsman. What sort of things do you draw then?
Well, heating and ventilating and plant rooms and stuff like that.
Uh-huh. And Yvonne has rather a different job. Tell us what you do.
I'm a chiropodist.
I go to a chiropodist here at the Queen's in Leeds. He's a marvellous fella, actually. I said to him, I'm suffering with my corn. He said, everyone is suffering with your corn. I love this. Listen to this. The two of them met at a foot-and-mouth disco.
That's right.
for dentist and chiropodist. And, Dave, you had to wear a set of old dentures around your neck on a chain.
That's right. Well, I'm not a dentist. It was the only way I could get in.
So what did chiropodist wear? A pair of old socks around the neck?
No,
oh, good. Anyway, it's good that the two of you are here. Let's have your questions, shall we? I know. Thanks very much, Yvonne. They're a bit naughty, our crew here. You said you didn't wear anything and they went right ahead of that one. Okay. No, no, that gets worse. Don't say any more. Okay, you know the procedure. Answer alternately. We'll let you have one to start with. Just be careful with guesses, so good luck. Again, your question is about the names of people in the world of sport. We give you the surname of an internationally known sports person. We want you to give the first name by which they are best known. Now, McIlroy, the footballer, has the first name Sammy. We'll start you with that one. McIlroy and?
Sammy.
Right, Riordan.
Pass.
Navratilova.
Pass.
Gower.
Pass.
Lendl.
Ivan.
Cram.
Pass.
Carson.
Pass.
Bristow.
Eric.
Faldo.
Pass.
And Mansell.
Nigel.
Yes, Nigel, right. Good. Took a shot by the sound of it, but you got it right. Well done. Good for you. That was right. Faldo, of course, was Nick Faldo. Carson, Willie Carson, somebody who's related, I think, to Felix Bowness. Cram is Steve Cram. Gower is David Gower, Navratilova, of course, Martina, and Riordan was Ray Riordan. What have you got? You've got four right, so you've got £40. Not bad. Off you go with Caroline. See you in round two as we say hello to couple number three. Somebody. Somebody a little smaller.
Yes,
lovely.
It's nice
that you're here.
It?
Who's couple number three then, Linda?
We have Mick and Adele Webb from Leeds.
Ah, our married couple, yes, from Leeds. Right. Nearly got a round of applause then. You nearly did. Not quite. Lovely. How do you think so? Local. Make them feel at home. What part of Leeds are you from?
Yeadon.
Yeadon? Oh, out by the airport. You don't get kept awake by planes and things, do you?
No.
Good. I see that, Nick, you're a partner in a hairdressing salon. Does that mean you do the partings? Or, I mean, you and Adele, you're both partners. She's the boss at work and you're the boss at home?
Am I?
He likes to think he is.
Yeah. Now, do you do all sorts of hairstyles, like these, the punk ones with the different hair, colour hair and all that? Do you?
We don't have a lot of colour for it in Yeadon.
No.
Well, it's a very sensible place.
Yeah, well, we got somebody in our street with so many colours in his hair, you know, he doesn't get dandruff, he gets confetti. Adele, it says here you persuaded Mick to have blonde highlights, really?
Yeah.
Well, great. Looks good, too, doesn't it?
Good story behind it, though.
Is there?
A long story.
A long one. Well, I don't think we've got time for that.
No,
yeah, I've got some grey hair. I know that's hard to believe, but I've got some somewhere. Nothing wrong with grey hair. Ask any bald man. He'll tell you. Let's have the questions. Thanks a lot, Linda. Thank you. The last one means that's the one for you. But remember, you do get the free choice in the next round. So good luck to you. The question, again, is about names of people in the world of sport. We give you the surname of an internationally known sports person. We want you to give the first name by which they are best known. Now, McLaughlin, the cyclist, has the first name, Joey. We'll start you with that one. McLaughlin and?
Joey.
Maradona.
Diego.
Bud.
Don't know.
Gatting.
Mike.
Starkey.
Don't know.
Torville.
Pass.
Bruno.
Don't know.
Thorburn.
Cliff.
Mandlikova.
Don't know.
Matthew.
Any.
Oh, dear, that was so close. Any. No, it was, in fact, Addy. What a shame. He deserves a round of applause for getting that close. Sorry about that, Nick. Addy, yes. Who, in fact, of course, is a British sprinter, a great sprinter as well. Mandlikova was Hannah Mandlikova, of course, who got to the women's final with Martina Navratilova. Bruno, of course, Frank Bruno, Torville, Jane Torville, Starkey, Greville Starkey. Bud was Zola Bud, and that's about it, isn't it, at the end of that? Yes, what have we got? Four right gives you £40. That's even. At the moment. So, at the end of the first round of our quiz, we got couple number two. That's Nick and Yvonne. Couple number three, Adele and Mick. They're on £40, but in the lead at the moment, our couple number one, Dave and Jackie, they've got £60. Nice and even as we go into the second round questions, and you get the free choice, Adele, this time. Number three you want. Good luck to you. You go for this time £40 for each correct answer, and your question is about the names of films which have been seen in this country during the past 3 years. We will give you the beginning of the name of the film. We want you to finish it. Now, Angela Carter's stories gave rise to the film The Company of Wolves. OK? We'll start you with that one. The Company of...
Wolves.
Right. Indiana Jones and the Temple of...
Doom.
The Killing... 1980.
Pass.
Give my regards to.
Pass.
Young Sherlock.
Holmes.
Dance with a...
Don't know.
My Beautiful.
Laundrette.
Romancing the...
Don't know.
Defence of the...
Pass.
Defence of the Realm, one I wasn't familiar with at all. Romancing the Stone, that was a very big movie, of course, with Michael Douglas. Dance with a Stranger. Give My Regards to Broad Street, that was the Paul McCartney film, yes. 1984, I thought you might have had that one. Yeah, go on, tell him off. What have you got there? £200 you have. Well done. 200. Off you go with Linda, as we welcome back couple number two. Okay. Nick and Yvonne are here. Which one are you going to choose this time? Nick goes for number one. All right, keep it nice and tight as you go. Also for £40 for each correct answer. The question the same about the names of films which have been seen in this country during the past 3 years. We will give you the beginning of the name of a film. We want you to finish it. Now, a recent thriller film was Jagged Edge. So we'll start you with that one. Jagged
Edge.
Back to the
future.
A passage to
India.
A view to a
kill.
Pritzi's. The Cotton
Club.
Down and Out in Beverly
Hills.
Letter to
Brezhnev.
Paris. Paris. Yes. And Places in the
Sun.
No, I'd have gone like that. I wouldn't have known that either, would you? Places in the Heart, it was. A great movie, I hear. Paris, Texas was what we wanted. Pritzi's Honor, the Jack Nicholson film. And that's about it. You've done enormously well. Yeah, £280 you got. Good. Off you go with Caroline as we welcome back couple number one. Matt and Dave. Dave and Jackie, thanks, Linda. Last envelope means that's the one for you this time. That's it. Hold him nice and tight there. And you go for £60 for each correct answer with the same question about the names of films which have been seen in this country during the past 3 years. We will give you the beginning of the name of the film. We want you to finish it. Now, a recent British film was Morons from Outer Space. So we'll start you with that one. Morons from
Outer Space.
Right. Falling in.
Pass.
Desperately Seeking
Susie.
Oh, I'm sorry about that. No, it wasn't Susie. It's Desperately Seeking Susan, the film, of course, which Madonna starred in. The other one was Falling in Love. So I'm afraid you only have the £60 you won at the end of the first round, but I think they deserve a round of applause anyway, don't you? There we are. So at the end of our quiz this week, we have couple number one, that's Dave and Jackie from Liverpool, they have £60. We have couple number three, that's Mick and Adele on £200. Winners of our quiz this week, couple number two, Nick and Yvonne, £280. Yeah, I do feel sorry for you on that one when it happens early on like that. But you were so close, but unfortunately those are the rules. But you've been a smashing couple. It's been so bubbling the whole time. You're not going to have a row on the way back,
are you? No.
Don't go back. Well, we don't want you to do that because we want you to stay with us. Wait until after the show, will you? There's the £60.
Oh, yeah. Thanks so much.
Yeah. Jackie gets
thank
the
you.
Bin. Right. Dave gets... And don't, if you have any trouble, give us a call. Dave, thanks a lot. Stay with us. Enjoy the show.
Thanks so much.
We're going to see you after the break. Don't go far away, will you? Money there. Okay, welcome to part two of 3-2-1 Rock. Down the Ages is our theme this week, and we have Nick and Yvonne, who are from Twickenham in Middlesex, engaged, playing against Mick and Adele from Yeadon in Leeds, married, right? You know what happens here? At the end of each one of our items we're about to show you, one of our guests is going to come here to the table, leave a clue object, read a rhyme. When there are three here on the table, you choose one to reject if you are the lucky couple who gets through the elimination question. So, good luck to you. Item number one, Rock Down the Ages, and we start with a classic Cole Porter number, Blow Gabriel Blow, given the rock gospel treatment by the Irving Davis Dancers.
Sound.
Yes, we hear that sound.
Do you know that sound?
What's that sound? Why, it's Gabriel, Gabriel, Flynn. ready to go when I blow my horn.
Come on and blow, Gabriel, blow. Blow, Gabriel, blow.
I've been a sinner, I've been a scamp, but now I'm willing to trim my lamp.
So blow, Gabriel, blow.
I was heading for hell.
I was heading
yes,
for
I was
hell.
Heading for hell. But when I got to Satan's door, I heard you blowing on your horn once more. So I said, Satan, farewell.
And now I'm ready, 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 ready to fly.
Oh, I'm ready to fly.
Great number there. Now, what are you going to leave these people here as a clue?
Here, Gabriel's horn.
Oh, Gabriel's horn is the clue for you. Okay. And what about the rhyme? What does that say?
Making it. Gabriel shows how you ought to, somewhat Irish, where you cross the water.
Adele, yes. We all feel the same. In one, you got that. Let's thank Tony of the Irving Davis Dancer. Thanks, Tony. All the best. Yeah. Hey, you're thinking about something over. It's always difficult on the first one, mind you. I find it difficult on everyone. Have you any idea about that one?
Not a clue.
Not yet. Well, it's a bit early. You don't either, have you?
Trip to Ireland.
Oh, really? Keep thinking that way and talking to each other. You can listen to the folks in the audience, but you've got to make up your minds. Remember that. We'll have item number two, then, of Rock Down the Ages. And here we have for you all the fun of the fair. Three shapely blondes. Three ladies who have been causing quite a stir in show business of late, here with an equally appealing number, Love Blonde. Will you welcome the Foxes?
Only you won't. If you got that savoir-faire.
Are you, Vicky? Super. Lovely act. Knockout. You're a lovely girl. It's a lovely number, that. What are you leaving him here as a clue?
I'm leaving you some pink gin.
Don't touch it.
I nearly drank it. I nearly drank it before I came.
Pink gin. How about that clue?
Right, the clue. The fox has entirely gone to ground, hunting the sound that goes with the hound.
There you are. That's even easier than the first one, isn't it?
Yeah.
Let's thank the little foxes, Vicky.
Thanks, Ted.
All the best. Good luck. Bye-bye. A little bit more chat this time, huh? Yes, there is. Over here, certainly. What do you think about that? Any idea?
Don't know yet. Hunting the sound.
Well, there's one more on the table, then you've got to really start making up your mind what you're going to reject if you get through that question. So just keep thinking as we go on and have item number three of Rock Down the Ages. And here's a group with a fine pop pedigree. They had 15 hits in 3 years. Here with their chart-topping Tiger Feet, welcome, please, Mud. Great. I haven't seen you for a while, but I know you've been enormously busy all around the world, yeah?
All over the place.
That's right, yeah. I'm not surprised after that number. What are you leaving the folks here as a clue?
A bin end.
Oh. A bin end is the clue, right? Now, listen to this, because it's the last one you're going to have, right?
This time, sink it if it's left at sea. If that's at home, that's where you'll be.
Have you any idea about this last one that came in, the bin end?
Seems a bit too
Yeah.
Does it? A bit too obvious. Well, I can read the other two again. Okay, you've just heard the bin end, which came in from Les there. Remember, Gabriel's horn came in item number one from Tony of the Irving Davis Dancers. He said, making it, Gabriel shows how you oughter, somewhat Irish, when you cross the water. Okay. That was the first one. Pink gin came in item number two from Vicky of the Foxes. She said, the fox has entirely gone to ground, hunting the sound that goes with a hound. So there you are, three here on the table. What one are you going to reject if you get through?
We think the horn.
You all think Gabriel's
horn? For the horn as well, yeah.
Everyone's going to go for Gabriel's horn. That we know. I've got the question here, so put your hands, please, by that button there. When you think you know the answer, hit the button and answer. Don't answer before you hit the button, otherwise I do have to offer it to the other couple, all right? So very good luck to you all. And here is the question. This singer was once an apprentice with Brentford Football Club. He had a much publicised liaison with Britt Eklund. His version of Maggie May was, says Mick.
Rod Stewart.
Rod Stewart, you're right. You hovered, but you're right. Yeah. And I saw Nick go at one point. Yeah. You weren't too sure.
I wasn't sure.
Did you, was it Rod Stewart you thought?
I thought Elton John.
Elton John? See, I'd have offered it to you anyway. Well, anyway, congratulations. That means, of course, you're through. We have to say goodbye, unfortunately, to Nick and Yvonne. And Caroline's here with the money. What they win, Caroline?
£280.
Oh, 280 is not bad. That's good. And, of course, your ceramic dusty bin, Yvonne. And please, take a look across there, because Linda has for you a consolation prize of a mini TV clock radio. Look at that. That's nice, isn't it? Nice. Take care. All the best, Nick. Jolly good luck to you. Give them a round of applause. Good folks. Well done. Thanks so much. Okay, Adele. Now it really starts for you. You thought it was tough to get to this part, didn't you?
Yeah.
Okay. We know what it is. When we come back after the break, we're going to reject. That is Gabriel's horn. Any idea what you think it is? We know what you hope it is.
No idea.
We will see in just a couple of minutes. See you soon. 3, 2, 1. Rock down the edge. Good luck to you. Okay, it's part three of 3, 2, 1. Rock Down the Ages, our theme, and we've got Adele and Mick, who are from Yeadon in Leeds, got through to this part of the show. But we do know, of course, you've rejected, okay, Gabriel's horn. You haven't thought any more about it in the break, have you?
No.
Okay, remember, it came in item number one from Tony of Irving Davis Dancers. He said, making it, Gabriel shows how you oughter, somewhat Irish, when you cross the water. Right. Yes, Tony brought you Gabriel's horn and said, making it, Gabriel shows you how you oughter. Well, the name of the song was Blow, Gabriel, Blow, so whatever this is made by blowing. Somewhat Irish, where you cross the water. If the water is a stream or a river, you could cross it at a ford. And the Waterford is a place in Ireland, a place, in fact, known all over the world for some of the finest hand-blown glass crystal. Take a look at this.
Yes, a sparkling array of Waterford crystal consisting of 8 sets of glasses for all occasions. There's a matching fruit bowl, plus 2 decanters, all in beautiful cut glass traditional design. Would have made a truly magnificent prize.
A really lovely prize, that, so I'm afraid it's been rejected. So take it away, Linda. I'm so glad you didn't win that. I'm afraid to send anything else away. However, we're going to now look at item number 4. It's great to welcome back a young gentleman who did so well with this last time he was here. He's equally at home whether he's writing or performing. Please welcome Andrew O'Connor.
Thank you very much. As the theme tonight is rock through the ages, I thought I'd begin by playing you some heavy rock music. Some heavy rock music.
Thank you.
Thank you, music lovers. You know, I brought the rock from Blackpool on the train, and I must say I love travelling by train because British Rail have really improved it, you know. They're laying on special trains for different sorts of commuters. I mean, for the businessman, there's the Intercity to London. For pussy lovers, there's the Intercity to Catford. For comedians, the Interwitty to Loughborough. And for Samantha Fox, the inter... Anyway, it goes to Bristol. Joan Collins has got the best train. Joan Collins, she always travels on the Amateur Way Days Express. Think about it. It's great. Although, you know, whenever I travel on the train, I always get weird people coming up and talking to me. And they've always got, like, a newspaper under their arm and a strange look on the face. Hello. Hello. This is my newspaper. And on the front page of my newspaper, there's an article about a man who's 104 tomorrow. 104. And according to this, he wants to spend the day in bed with an 18-year-old blonde girl. Apparently, the Queen sent him a telegram, and Prince Andrew sent him a diagram. Then they always start telling you things that you don't want to know. Do you know how many newspapers it takes to plan a family? No, I don't know. Well, I'll tell you how many newspapers it takes to plan a family. You need two people, one male, a few mirrors, no observers, and as many times as you like. And if you're not on your guardian, you might get a son. Then they start getting really angry about something, don't they? There's an article in this newspaper about that Doris Stokes, you know, that medium, the one who reckons she can contact the dead. What a load of waddle. I could contact the dead, you could contact the dead, anybody could. All you have to do is pick up the telephone, dial 100 and wait. But then, right, then, if they find out what I do for a living, I've really had it. Oh, you're in show business, are you? I've done a bit myself, you know. I do impressions. Would you like to see one of my impressions? No. All right, but I'll show you one of my impressions. This is my impression of that bloke off the television from that programme, Minder. Here you go. Arthur Daly. You think I've just torn that newspaper, don't you? Well, yes, I do. Well, I haven't. This paper isn't torn at all. You might think I'm tearing it. You might think I'm having a ripping time. Doing a terrible thing, but I'm not. Because this paper isn't torn at all. It's completely normal. It's untorn. It's a virgin newspaper. Anyway, I've got to go now. I've got to get off. This is my stop. Goodbye. Goodbye. Goodbye.
Thank you. Hey, Andrew. How are you?
Okay.
Good.
Good.
Hey, good. And congratulations again on Copycats, eh?
Yeah, do you like it? Thank you.
Very good indeed. What are you leaving as a clue?
This is The Rock.
The Rock.
There you go. The Rock.
Okay, The Rock is the clue.
Yeah.
And what about the rhyme, Andrew?
Okay, this is the rhyme. See if you can get this right. Time for a trip, so pull your chances. More than a stone throw away enhances.
No, we haven't got any idea. We're going to thank Andrew O'Connor.
Cheers, mate. Okay, cheers.
Thanks, Andrew. What's a stone's throw away? What are you thinking about, Nick? That's good. You're thinking about something. Well, we have three on the table. I can read one of these two again if you'd like to refresh your memory on one of these two. What do you want to hear? The Bin End or the Pink Gin?
That one.
Yeah?
The Bottle.
Yeah, you want to hear? The Bin End is what it's called. Came in from Les Gray of Mud. He said, this time sink it if it's left at sea. If that's at home, that's where you'll be. Now, we have to reject one.
Of course, I think Bottle. Message in a bottle. Yeah. Sink it.
Sink or swim?
Yeah.
Yes?
We'll sink or swim
is going to go?
Yeah.
Okay. All right. You're going to reject the Bin End?
Yeah.
Okay. So rejecting then the Bin End came in item number three from Les Gray of Mud. This time sink it. If it's left at sea, if that's at home, that's where you'll be. Okay. What do we have for you? Okay.
Les brought you in the bin end and said this time sink it if it's left at sea. Left at sea would be port, and if you're sinking port, it must be the drinking variety, which ties in with that bin end. If that's at home, that's where you'll be. If the port is at home, it will be Portugal, and that's where this is a 3-2-1 holiday to Portugal.
Flight to Portugal in 2 weeks on the coast of the Algarve, where you could relax and soak up the sun. During your stay, you could enjoy some of the delicious local fare at a beach party, and of course there'll be plenty of opportunity for a chat with the locals while sampling their wine or persuading them to take you fishing. If you stay close to the town, you'll have a chance to haggle over the local produce. Sun, sea, and a chance to look at some of the traditional aspects of Portugal is what would have been a fabulous 3-2-1 holiday.
Oh dear, what a shame. A great 3-2-1 holiday. That wasn't just all, unfortunately. You were going to be guests at one of the top hotels in the area. Of course, there was car hire for you for the whole 2 weeks, and we'd arranged £300 worth of traveller's checks as well. So that's what's called rubbing your nose in it, isn't it? I'm sorry about that. Marvellous prize. Don't worry, keep your fingers crossed. Item number 5 of Rock Down the Ages. And here's a real hot property when it comes to pop groups. They've got 8 singles so far, and here with a track from the latest LP called Find the Time, 5-star are here. Jane. Massive. Lovely. Good to see you once again. A terrific act there. I know you've had a lot of success, and you are all a show business family, yes?
That's right.
Uh-huh. And what about this tour of America, then? Tell us about that.
Oh, we're just in the middle of our tour to the US. Uh-huh. We've been to LA, Detroit, so...
That's fabulous, eh? Really good. And that number's from your new album, which is called what?
Silk and Steel.
Silk and Steel. I'm sure that's going to do marvellously well for you. What are you going to leave these two folks here?
Well, this is a discus.
A discus, and it looks a little heavy, doesn't it? Yeah. A discus is the clue, and the rhyme says what?
The rhyme is, we turn the tables now and then. You've just heard five. Is it here again?
Is it Adele? We'll find out. Lorraine and Five Star. Good luck, Lorraine. All the best. Bye, bye, love. Oh, great. Oh, they're onto something straight away there.
Too quick was that, yeah. Discus. Turntable, hi-fi.
Yeah, what do you say, Adele? You don't care, you're just looking for the bin. It's here somewhere, isn't it? We know it's here somewhere. Well, you can hear one of these two again. What do you want to hear, the Pink Gin or Blackpool Rock?
The Rock.
The Rock, yeah.
Yes? Okay, yes, it was. It's indeed, it's Blackpool Rock. It came in from Andrew O'Connor, item number 4. Time for a trip, so pool your chances. More than a stone's throw, away enhances. So, here we go.
Stone's throw away, nearby, throw away.
Just bin.
Yeah. Bin end, Gabriel's horn. Well, you know.
Well, stone's throw away is like Stone Age, and Dusty Bin's dressed as a Stone Age man with a...
Yeah, he got it wrong, but that's right, yes, indeed. So what are you going to do? You have three here on the table.
We don't like that. I said I don't like rock, so we'll get rid of it.
That's what he said, and you put him in charge. But, you know, you are the boss sometimes, remember that.
I can shout at him afterwards.
But don't be hard on him in work tomorrow, will you? So what one's going to go this time?
The rock.
Is that all right with you folks? Oh, great. So that's it. You'll really give it to them. It's OK. It's going to be rejected. Yes?
Sure.
All right, then. You are going to reject, then. Blackpool Rock, item number 4 from Andrew O'Connor. Oh, God, here we go now. Time for a trip, so pool your chances. More than a stone's throw, away enhances. OK, so what do we have this time for you? Andrew brought you the stick of Blackpool Rock. He said, time for a trip, so pool your chances. Could the trip mean, here's where we trip you up? Or possibly, because the pool is, in this case, Blackpool, more than a stone's throw away enhances. Well, if you remember, Andrew threw away his stick of rock. You've done the same. It's Dusty Bin. You've done it. Oh, yes. Wonderful. Yeah, I don't have to ask if you like that. Dusty, you've been rejected. Off you go, my friend. Take him away. He's got to go. Wonderful. So that means a great prize goes home with you tonight. The final two on the table, being the last two, I can read them both again. Item number 2, the Pink Gin, came in from Vicky of the Foxes. She said, the fox has entirely gone to ground, hunting the sound that goes with the hound. Okay? Think what you want. This is the last one. Item number 5 came in from Lorraine of Five Star. She brought in a discus and said, we turn the tables now and then. You've just heard 5. Is it here again? So.
5 again.
You have a good prize. We know that. What one's going
to
go?
We stuck to the gin all the way through, haven't we?
Have you? Are you drinkers?
No.
You would? Yeah. Oh, you would? What a shame you're sitting up there. You're not here. Anyway, that's good. So what are we going to do? We're going to keep this?
Music things.
So you don't want music things?
No.
No?
We'll have quiet things.
And Mick? That's going to go?
Yeah.
Adele?
He
said, remember, that's twice I've heard it. You've got 2 stripes tomorrow when you're going to work. So you're going to keep this and get rid of this?
Stick with the gin.
Stick with the gin, so you're going to reject the discus, yes?
Yeah.
Yes? No back here. Okay, then. I haven't opened it yet. You're going to reject the discus. Lorraine brought this in from Five Star. We turn the tables now and then. You've just heard 5. Is it here again? We turn the tables now and then. Turning tables have an obvious connection with other types of music. You've just heard 5. Is it here again? The 5 you've just heard were the 5 stars from Five Star. Those and many more could be heard time and time again on this. Take a look. You're right.
This would have kept you rocking all right. It's the very latest in hi-fi equipment. You have a semi-automatic turntable, a digital tuner, Dolby B&C cassette player and compact disc, all wrapped up in this attractive rosewood cabinet. And to round it off, you would have got a voucher to start your record or compact disc collection.
How about that one then? Now then. Fabulous slide, you'll agree. Taking it away, Caroline, it's got to go. I'm sure you could have done with that, couldn't you, Nick?
Yeah.
And Adele, did you like that?
Yeah.
But we hope you're going to like this a bit more, don't we, huh? Okay. A pink gym, which came in item number two from Vicky of the Foxes. She said the fox has entirely gone to ground, hunting the sound that goes with a hound. Now then, okay, she brought you a pink gym. Pink, of course, has a hunting connection, and there are several more in that rhyme. So could this be one of our regular prizes for which you're hunting? Or could the gin mean a trap? I shouldn't think so now. The fox has entirely gone to ground. Well, there are other things that are entirely on the ground. Hunting the sound that goes with a hound. What sound goes with hunting? And with tires on the ground, the horn on the Ford Fiesta. Yes! Okay. Now then. How's that? Okay, let's go and get your car. Off you go. How about that? Oh, Adele. Marvellous. How about that? There you are. The star prize they got. And remember, that's it. Give them a big kiss. There's also money you won in the quiz, and Linda has that. Linda?
£200.
£200, folks. Congratulations, Mick. Well done. Super, Adele. Congratulations
to
you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'd like to thank all our guest artists, all our contestants, most of all you for watching. Till we see you next week, take care. Have a good week. Good night, everybody. Bye-bye.